Most of you would have come across a baby with a birth defect, so you might be wondering what causes a birth defect. We have different causes, and you could have a broad group. Malformation, where the formation is not complete, it's not proceeding as it should. This is like a glitch or error in the computer file, for example. So the genetic information could be abnormal. There could be changes in the genetic information called mutation, which dictates the tissue formation in a different way. There could be some other factor like a nutritional deficiency or a drug exposure, which affects the fetus formation in the embryonic stage. The next important factor is what we call disruption, when the organ is starting to be formed but something is actually disrupting it. One good example is amniotic band, where the band, the membrane which covers the baby, part of it becomes loose. It ties around a portion of the baby like a limb and it disrupts. Deformation, where something is formed but it is bent or deformed by space constraints. This could happen in multiple pregnancy. This could happen in a very small uterine sac in a mother who is young and the uterus is tight, for example, or it could be a uterine myoma or something else. One example of this deformation sequence is what happens with renal abnormalities which don't produce enough urine. This is called Potter sequence or Potter syndrome. So when the defective urine output is there, there is no fluid surrounding the baby, and this leads to a problem in the lung development because there needs to be fluid in the womb for the baby to breathe and the lung to develop. So this is called pulmonary hypoplasia. The baby may also have problems with physical features. Limbs are cramped and deformed, and you may have facial features which are abnormal as well. I hope this helps.